Hi, and welcome to Add More Zest. My name's Rebecca, also known as 4Kids147, and it's time for tip and trick number 51. So I actually did this whilst recently on a video while sorting out my AB diamonds. I have decided to keep them on rings. I'm trying to incorporate them more into paintings. And somebody actually commented and said that should be a tip and trick. Sometimes that's my problem. I forget that I sometimes just do these things or change the way I'm doing something and forget that it can be a tip and trick, which I know some people just tend to watch those. So, tip and trick number 51 is one that I actually did in a recent video for my AB diamonds, but it can be incorporated in a few different ways. So there are quite a few, or there are many diamond painters that may do diamond paintings from various different companies. Some people like to limit themselves to only a few. Some people even limit themselves to only one diamond painting company. Great if you do. I like to mix it up. I've got diamond paintings from multiple different companies. There are some that I prefer the diamond paintings from some companies over others. There's some I prefer the price of over others. But most companies, pretty much most companies, use the DMC system for the colour of the diamonds. So they will have, you know, DMC, for example, this one, DMC number 666 is red. DMC number 208 is a purple. And the shades are normally about the same. However, there are at least two companies, maybe more, that do use different numbers for their AB diamonds. So, for example, Diamond Art Club have their own numbering system for their AB diamonds. But they do provide a conversion. Diamond Dots actually use their own numbers for both the normal diamonds and the AB diamonds. And they in turn also provide a conversion to the DMC, if that's the way that you like to store your spares, which is what I do. So I've only done, I think, one or two Diamond Dots paintings. And I don't want to keep, if I only did them, I would keep their diamonds in their number system. But because I do them from multiple companies, I converted them before putting them away into my DMC, because that's what most companies use, and that's the quickest way for me. If you only use one company's diamonds, then it's probably, you will probably just decide to use their numbering system. But for ABs, I actually do quite a few Diamond Art Club paintings, or at least I have done. I've currently got one on the go. I think I have one more in my stash. I think it's Megan that has most of them in her stash. So I'm currently doing one. But for their ABs, I also have ABs that have the diamond, have the DMC number. So that's how I like to store them, with the DMC number. But what I did when I recently de-kitted is, so for example here, 666, that is the DMC number. AB107 is the Diamond Art Club number. 605, Diamond Art Club don't have an equivalent, so I've not put the sticker there. For 603, Diamond Art Club use 113. Now, these diamonds didn't come out of a Diamond Art Club, because I know the Diamond Art Club ones I've done in my head. But if I ever did have a Diamond Art Club that I was de-kitting, I could look at their code or the DMC code. It really doesn't matter. Same here, 124 they use. And mine are stored by colour. 208. So, in fact, I think it's the blues. So, the blues. So we've got here one AB136, 137. This has got some Diamond Art Club ABs in it, but it's also got some ABs from another company. So they're both stored in the same bag. That one may well have some from both, or maybe it's that 120. This one definitely does. So 5200 and AB141, that definitely has diamonds in from both companies. From two different companies, sorry, rather than both companies. That definitely has one in from both companies. But now what I find when I'm de-kitting and I'm de-kitting my ABs, because I don't have a huge amount, Diamond Art Club don't do all DMC numbers in an AB. I can't actually remember. How many do they have? 3, 6, 9, 12, 15, 18. This is where my brain's going. 20, 18, 21, 24, my brain's going 24, 27, 30, 33, 36, 39, 40, 41. So they now have 41 AB colours available. So it's not all of them, but if you decide to store yours in DMC, you can always pop both codes next to it, and it might help you be a little bit quicker when you're de-kitting, or it may just help in the fact that you can cross-check them both off. So for me, with de-kitting ABs, it's ideal because I just go to the blues, I'll have a look. Is it any of these Diamond Art Club codes that I've already got on the blues? If it is, great, it goes in the bag. Job done. If it's not one of these that I've already got, then I need a new bag anyway. So then I'll look up the DMC conversion code and I'll put both stickers on the bag so that the next one in the future will have both. So some of these that have both codes on, the diamonds never came from Diamond Art Club, but I've got them both down anyway. And that will make it a lot easier for me when de-kitting. If you find that you yourself are forever looking up the conversion from one company, whether it be Diamond Art Club or not, they're just a very big company and a very popular company, so it's the easiest one to mention. But if you find that you're always converting, then maybe have both stickers on there. So have two stickers, so that you know which one it is. If you only ever use Diamond Art Club, then you probably just need to use their code. But anyway, yeah, that's a little tip and trick if you do want to save yourself a little bit of time when you de-kit a kit that uses a different set of numbers, and that may help you in the de-kitting process. And it looked kind of pretty with both stickers as well, so that's always good. Anyway, thank you so much for watching, and I'll speak to you all again soon.